You are at a critical moment in your history as a city. You're on the cusp of seeing a lot of the change that was long envisioned and hoped for. So as Halifax grows as a hub in Atlantic Canada, what does it look like as a city of the future?
Create high quality public spaces has been very important to create different qualities, different activities, contrasts and drama.
Where people of all ages, socioeconomic classes, and walks of life can live.
And I can't emphasize enough the need for spaces where diverse opinions can be heard and respected.
You need a sustained conversation, a sustained debate, and that's not a bad thing. That's a good thing.
When we talk about the art of city building, we are talking about cities which are going to have to deal with climate change, deal with automation, deal with biodiversity losses of a scale and order that we've never seen before, and deal with the fundamental inequalities which are concentrating wealth in the hands of the few.
I think that we're at a historic turning point. We're at this moment when technology is becoming the infrastructure of our daily lives, and we have an opportunity, and it's a fast shrinking window, to decide what we want that infrastructure to look like.
Math and science is not inherently capitalist. We don't have to always be using technology in ways that it is to make money. There's a whole other realm that's available to us.
The most measured thing you will have in all of the databases of the city will be how vehicles move. The assumption behind it is the more vehicles pass through, the better it is for the system.
If you design your community around cars and traffic, you get more cars and traffic. When you design your community around people and places, you get more people and places.
We're going to show some of our new renderings of our new building for the new Friendship Center. That building means so much more than just the bricks and mortar. It's true reconciliation.
What are those Indigenous names that are visible in your cities? What is the meaning of those, and how do we bring those to life through activations?
Good morning. Welcome to the 4th Annual Art of City Building Conference. My name is Mike Savage, and I'm the mayor of the great city of Halifax. Whether you're tuning in from Halifax or points beyond, I hope you enjoy this opportunity to engage with so many others who are working to make our cities more livable, sustainable, and welcoming to diverse populations.
COVID presented one emergency, a pandemic, a public health emergency, but as the mayor just underlined, actually, there's a climate emergency happening concurrently with that.
Climate change and the solutions, I think, are about framing. All the kind of solutions that I keep hearing are sustainable transportation, sustainable agriculture, green buildings. Yes, these are part of the solution, but we have to really agree on what one of the main drivers is, and that is inequality.
I feel like we've created a socially and physically divided city. The single family house on the left, that housing takes up 81% of the residential land in Vancouver, but that kind of housing is affordable to just 2.5% of Vancouverites.
We need everybody to make the change as we continue to diversify, and then we also need to meet people where they are. We can't be surprised that it's only the NIMBYs who show up to our meetings and our regular places at the regular times, right?
You know, major pandemics and other crises have historically played the role of being switching points. The learning experiences that we get from that can be transformative.